I think we're going to go into mortgages now.
Right? Okay, let's go mortgages.
That's all right.
Okay, just no alcohol.
Can we talk alcohol first?
We can talk alcohol first. I mean, if you want to drink. Joel Olandeska, your mortgage planner with Mortgage Architects, and you're going to tell us what we need to do to get a mortgage.
What do we need to do?
I don't have one, so I'm going to listen.
And thanks for this, by the way.
Oh, you're welcome.
You're very welcome. Can you explain this real quickly, what this is?
Yeah, sure. So these are tabletop portable chargers. They'll charge a number of phones, 20 to 30 completely. So they last quite a while. They last
charging yourself right now.
Charging right now.
Thanks, courtesy of
Charging. SOS charging.
And a great logo on there.
We need all these at our
Yeah, Go Flames Go.
Everyone on their phones.
Okay, sorry. Just want to get that out of the way.
Okay, so let's talk mortgages. Well, as everybody knows, because we hear it everywhere, mortgage rates are low, low, low. You know, we all like to say mortgage rates are low. I don't always like to say that that's your number one factor that you should be considering, right?
Oh,
so mortgage
really?
Rates can be low. Mortgage rates are mortgage rates are mortgage rates is how I like to say it to people that I'm working with. Because behind your actual mortgage, there are a number of factors that you need to consider. Payout penalties, prepayment privileges, payment increase privileges, right? So there are a number of features that you can get from lender to lender to lender before you get your mortgage. And those are the types of things that you want to look into before you actually get a mortgage. I always use the example of a car, right? So you can go from one dealership to another and get one particular car for the same price.
Mm.
However, if you go from manufacturer to manufacturer, each manufacturer is going to offer a different number of features within those cars.
Incentive, possibly?
Incentives, perhaps. So rates, yes, those are awesome. They're amazingly low right now. And it looks like they're going to be like that for quite a while. Is that a factor? Of course it is. But make sure you take care of or look into your other features behind. Right?
So maybe if somebody's looking to buy right now, where they're seeing some cheaper prices on the market, they're seeing a low mortgage rate, is it a good time to buy, or should they wait it out because eventually mortgage rates are going to go up, or how does that work?
If we take a look at all the factors that are happening right now, it definitely is a good time to buy. I'm not just saying that because I'm in the industry or, you know, that's what we're talking about today. If you look at every single factor that's out there, mortgage rates are low. The inventory of homes that are out there is a lot higher than it was at this point last year. Lenders are being very, very good with what they're offering feature-wise. And then a number of other factors that we need to consider is there are going to be some increases in insurance premiums as of June 1st. So if you're kind of sitting on the fence in regards to buying now or later on this summer, now's a really good time to take a little bit of a step further
so
to consider that.
So what if you don't have enough money to go out and buy something for your first place? I just want to touch on this because a lot of parents are actually helping their kids now. Mm-hmm. Would now be a good time to call up your father or mother and ask to maybe help out?
Yeah, there's actually a study done just very recently by CMHC, or the Canadian Mortgage Housing Corporation, and the number of gifted down payments has actually increased in the last year. Mm-hmm. And that's even on top of the gifting rules being changed. So they've been a lot more stringent in terms of how you can gift a down payment to someone else, whether it's a parent or whatever it may be. They've got to be at an arm's length relationship with you. But anyhow, it's increased, so people are definitely helping each other out when it comes to getting a mortgage.
Do you partner up with realtors?
All the time.
All the time?
All the time.
And by doing that, is it an advantage for me, the consumer?
Of course it is.
How so?
Because when you're going to be investing in a home, something that you're going to be in for a while, you want to make sure that you're teamed up with a correct group of individuals, from your mortgage broker to your stager, to your realtor, to your lawyer, to your insurance, right? So you want to make sure you have a complete set of a team.
You two agree with this?
Because you just have more people looking out for you too,
and that's exactly.
We all have your back. We talked before the show about it being like one of the, if not the biggest emotional decisions you're going to make at a certain time in your life. So you need to be taken care of, and that's easy for us to say as a panel and for what we do in our industry. But man, I'll tell you, the clients that trust us enough to say, okay, well, I've got I've got Joel in my back pocket, essentially. He's great at what he does. I've got Bree. She's going to help you with the staging and everything. We're going to package it all up. That creates a huge advantage when you're going forward listing a property for that kind of money.
Yeah. Exactly. Yeah. And it doesn't necessarily mean that the individuals that you're working with have to know each other. Mm-hmm. I think there's just a matter of making sure that the communication is there.
Good.
Yeah.
Communication is probably the number one factor when it comes down to everything, because you want to make sure that's a smooth process. I think in our case, one of the top priorities for us is making sure that our clients or everybody that we're working with feels comfortable from beginning to end. Mm-hmm. Making sure that they're confident with what they're going through.
Right.
Because let's be honest,
a little scary.
If you're going to be getting a mortgage for, let's say, the average of $350,000, mm-hmm, over the next 25 years, that's a big amount of...
It's a big chunk of change.
A big chunk of change to take on.
So if I know if I have a team representing me or supporting me,
that's
feel a little bit more at ease.
That's
Maybe you throw a lawyer into the mix. Somebody's got to write up the paper.
Yeah, I think, of course.
Definitely.
And advising clients of just that. Make sure you are with somebody who you're comfortable with, so that when it comes to crunch time and something goes sideways, you've got somebody who's got your back
behind you.
For the right reasons. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Great stuff.